Are you good at finding mistakes in BPMN models? Here's a challenge for you. Hi, my name is Andreas Hense and I make videos on business process automation. Today I'll present 6 BPMN diagrams with modeling mistakes. This is an interactive video that requires you to make use of the pause button. I'll present a model and ask you to hit the pause button. You can then look at the model as long as you like. When you continue the video, I'll tell you the solution. All clear? Then let's start. This is the first model. You can now hit the pause button and find the modeling mistake. So here the problem is the missing end event. There's a rule that says that every path in the diagram must start by a start event and end with an end event. And so in this model, we have the missing end event after node rejection. So there are 2 ways of fixing this. The first one would be to just add the missing end event here. If you have process models with more than one end event, it's good practice to somehow, note the end event here. What is the result here? And if we look at this process, create purchase request and so on and so forth, complete payment, then we can say purchase request successful, for example. And the other one would be purchase request rejected. So we have 2 different end events, and it's also good practice, but that's another topic, to tell what is the triggering condition for this workflow. So goods, new goods needed, for example, and then we have it. So that is one way of fixing the problem. The other way of fixing the problem would be to just have only one end event, and then to insert an XOR join in this case. Here in this diagram, and now we have the XOR join, so the path ends with the end event, and the end event is now only one for the whole process. This is the second model. You can now hit the pause button and find the modeling mistake. So in this process model, we have used implicit splits and joins. We have an implicit split after request cars, and we can see that 2 arcs are going out of this task. And here at prepare rental agreement, we have 2 incoming arcs. And using these implicit splits and joins is possible in BPMN, but I would not recommend that. So that's maybe, maybe one mistake that's here. But what is worse is that in BPMN, and I think that's not a good design in BPMN, is that the semantics of the implicit split in BPMN is an AND split, and the semantics of the implicit join is an XOR join. So that's really not symmetrical, and I'll show you with a token simulation what that means. So if we start the token simulation here, you can see that 2 tokens are produced, and then that handover car is, and also prepare rental agreement is executed twice. I'll just show it again. So you can see these two tokens, and that is definitely not what we want here. So how can we repair that? We have to insert explicit splits and joins, and I'll just make a little more space here. So what do we want? Request car. I mean, we have to ask, is the customer new or is the customer known? So we would insert an XOR split here, and we would put new customer question mark, and then we would say no. And here, we would say yes. And then we need to make the XOR join, put it in here, and now the diagram is correct. This is the third model. You can now hit the pause button and find the modeling mistake. So here we have this process select destination, and the question is how far is it away? What is the distance here? And we have less than 100, and the question, of course, is it 100 kilometers or miles? So let's say less than 100 kilometers, greater or equal to 100 kilometers, and greater or equal to 1,000 kilometers. The mistake here is that if we have an XOR split, we need to take exactly one of the outgoing branches. And you may have noted that the conditions here are not disjoint. So less than 100 kilometers, greater or equal to 100 kilometers, and greater or equal to 1,000 kilometers. So if we have 200 kilometers, it belongs to both categories, and we would be dependent on the implementation, for example, which of the branches is chosen. So in order to make that clear, we have to add here something like greater or equal to 100 kilometers and less than 1,000 kilometers. And then this is repaired. This is the fourth model. Hit the pause button and look for the modeling mistake. So what is wrong here? It's easy to see if we do a token simulation. We start here. Request rental car, check a rental request, and then we have a token here in front of the AND join, and the AND join is now waiting for another token on the other branch, on the lower branch, which can never arrive, and that is why we have a deadlock here. And so this process diagram doesn't have the soundness condition, and that's why it's wrong, so it can never go to the end successfully. And repairing it is very easy. We just have to replace the AND join by an XOR join here, so we have an exclusive gateway here. And now this is correct. Note that the correspondence between the split and the join here in a structured case is a good idea, But this is not always the case, as we may have spaghetti structures in process diagrams. This is the fifth model. Hit the pause button and look for the modeling mistake. So here this simple process starts with a condition new employee hired, and then we have the task grant system access. Then we have an intermediate condition prepare workstation. Then we have the task conduct orientation, and then employee onboarded is the end condition here. The problem here is that this condition here in the middle, prepare workstation, this is not really a condition. I mean, prepare workstation, this sounds like a task. And the correct workflow would look a little different here. So we would say prepare workstation is not an event, but prepare workstation is a task. So then, and this is the correct process diagram. This is the sixth and final model. Hit the pause button and find the modeling mistake. So this process model starts with books need to be returned. So the first task is enter the library, hand over books to a librarian, and then check book condition. And then we have an XOR split. Is the condition good? If yes, we go on straight. If not, we go down here and we issue a fine for the damaged book. And then at the end, we do update library record. So what is wrong here? This is a modeling mistake that I've seen frequently when beginners start modeling. It is a confusion between singular and plural, having all your books return to your library and then entering the library. And then here we have check book condition. So this is the condition of only one book. And of course, the books don't necessarily all have the same condition. So this isn't possible. The trigger for this whole process is that all books have to be returned to the library. And here we have something in the middle where we talk about one book. Is there a way to repair this? And the answer is yes, there is a way to repair this. We need a little more space to do this, and I will cut out this one here. And move this. Oh. Let me move this part up here. So what we need is, after handing over the books to the librarian, we need a sub-process, and we can either have a collapsed or an expanded sub-process. I will choose an expanded sub-process now. And this sub-process here has now its own start event. And what we can do now here inside the sub-process is we can start with check book condition. No. Check book condition. Then we have the XOR split. We ask, is the condition good? And in the case of yes, we go to another, to this XOR join, and then here we go to the end of this subprocess. And in the other case, we say issue fine for damaged book. Yeah, and I mean, yeah, we make it beautiful at night in general. No, this is not correct. So then we can delete this part. And now what we have to do is we have to change this subprocess to something that is multi-instance. And we can choose between parallel multi-instance and sequential multi-instance. And I will choose sequential multi-instance now. And now what we have now is the overall process is about going to the library with all your books in your bag, and the sub-process is about single books, and that is now the correct way. And here we have a starting condition, book needs to be checked. And then we can say book returned. So this is the singular part of the process model. And then we have books returned at the end. That's all for today. Let me know how many problems you have solved. Is there anything that is unclear? Looking forward to your comments.